Prior to human alterations in the falls beginning in the mid-1800s, coho salmon, sea-run cutthroat trout, fall schnook, and other temporal runs of steelhead were unable to pass the falls, and there were thus no populations of any of these species in the Willamette or any of its tributaries above the falls. Significant stocking operations, which were curtailed in the 1990s, established a self-sustaining population of coho upstream.
The ducks, that's the only thing entertaining.
See the sea lions? On the dock? See the sea lions in the water? Yep.
Oh. They're fine. You got my soul at your feet. Frankly, I'd rather watch sea lions eat fish, you know? Really? And go down. If you went fishing and catch one, you catch one.
That's what makes it a sport.
I've never really seen sea lions frolic in the water.
Likewise, fall chinook and early winter and summer steelhead have also become established, with returning adults now ascending the falls via fish ladders. The population of fish passing the Willamette Falls has fluctuated widely since 1950, generally around a mean of 40,000 fish, most of which are likely hatchery origin. Means these are hatchery fish. The sea lions are being killed for eating. Willamette River steelhead pass over the Willamette Falls. Researchers could not conclusively identify a single population that was naturally self-sustaining. The 2005 status review stated that most natural origin spring-run chinook population in the upper Willamette River are likely extirpated. There is a huge inequity when beautiful, intelligent, social, and gregarious sea lions are being trapped and killed for eating toxic fish from a river where all the resident and migrating fish come with consumption and preparation warnings.
That's how they get run over.
There was no reason. You're not supposed to go next to the docks like that anyway.
See that big gaff with the hook?
Frankly, I'd rather watch sea lions eat fish, you know? Really? And go down. If you went fishing and catch one, you catch one.
That excerpt was taken from the technical report by Stillwater Sciences, dated October 2017. Its title was Willamette Falls Legacy Project Baseline Habitat Conditions.